You can call it a long block, a crate engine, or remanufactured engine, but there's critical things on the vehicle that you need to address to make sure that new engine lasts a long time. We're going to find out what they are next.
This video is sponsored by Nissan, innovation that excites. Visit partsadvantage.nissanusa.com for more information.
We all have customers that have had a vehicle that has extreme amount of value to them, and it's not unforeseen for them to put a brand new engine in after they've experienced a failure, either due to water ingestion or lack of maintenance. When an engine is replaced, you need to make sure that the components going back on that remanufactured long block or crate engine are in proper working order to make sure that they'll keep that new engine alive. Here's some things you need to look for. The number one area that's typically missed by a technician when they're replacing an engine, it's the intake manifold. Often the previous engine has had a catastrophic failure, and sometimes debris can find its way into the intake manifold. A modern intake manifold, well, it has chambers and valves that debris can become lodged in and trapped. And when it's reinstalled on the new engine, well, that debris can get into the new engine and possibly harm it. So make sure that you check the intake manifold so there's no debris inside. You always want to inspect the cooling system. If an engine's failed, chances are it's contaminated the cooling system. This could be debris or other fluids in the system. It may be tough flushing all of these fluids out. It could be trapped in the heater core, but in some cases it's trapped in the radiator, and often a lot of this debris can block the channels inside the radiator. It may make sense to replace the whole radiator on some vehicles that have had a catastrophic failure of the engine. You should always look at the motor mounts before you install the new engine. Make sure they're in proper working order, that there's no separation, cracking, or a large amount of play in the existing motor mounts. If there are, you're gonna wanna replace them now instead of having a comeback later on. So those are just three quick tips, but the main thing to do is check the service information before you install the new engine. Make sure that you're following the correct torque specs and procedures for removing and installing the new engine. This way, it'll be right the first time. I'm Andrew Markel. Thank you very much.